how do we control the machine? So there's quite a lot going on. Can be overwhelming sometimes with the amount of adjustments we've got with the machine. But the idea of the tutorials is that we can explain things step by step and really how to get the best out of the machine. So the basic things we need to learn about in the first instance is what does what? What changes speeds, what lifts things up and down. So the easiest way to start with that one is showing you our, really just our basic control system. Does what it says on the tin is what it does. So we're going to talk about this six row machine. And when I say a six row, we're talking about six pairs of rollers. And to fine tune the machine, we need to think about speeds, the positions of the clod roller, or the steel one here, or the P roller, and how we change these speeds and positions and gaps to get the most balanced aggression on the machine, to get the best cleaning, protect the crop, to get the, what we need the machine to do. So we do, or we can offer two different systems. This is our basic analog system, if you like. So it's a manual speed controllers with potentiometers, reversing switches, good old emergency stop, and so on. Our other option is a PLC-based system, which is programmable. It's a little bit, quite a bit more expensive, as you'd imagine. But the idea of the PLC system is we can have a menu, and within that menu, we can save 10 parameters. So if you like, 10 settings of speeds, positions and whatnot. And so somebody who's not working with the machine regular can then just go to that system and we can preset those from the most extreme wet, heavy conditions all the way back to easier going, lighter soiled, smaller potatoes, right down to dry conditions where there really is no cleaning to be done and we just want to convey the crop over. So we can do all of those presets in the PLC system. It's really very good, especially if you've got a situation where you've got different shifts, multiple operators, but it comes at a price. It certainly comes at a price. So, right, let me tell you about the basic stuff and what you really need to know. At the end of the day, this will do everything that your PLC will do, but it won't remember, so you have to write it down. Six row machines, we build them in a certain way to get the best out of the machine. So let's talk about the spiral rollers for a start. We always talk about the spiral rollers or the fluted roller, if you want to call it that. So the grey rollers, on this machine we've got six shafts, and we're not interested really in adjusting each individual speed of every roller. It's just too much, too complicated, and it's just not as easy to set how we want it to be. So on the six row system, we do split it up. We have the first two rollers on one controller, and then we have the next four on the second controller. And it's as simple as we've got 0 to 10, and we're just looking to adjust all of those speeds to match the flow of crop. Generally speaking, on these six row machines, we ask a lot of them. There's a lot of soil, there's a lot of crop coming onto the table at the beginning. We'll often run the first two rollers, maybe just a little bit quicker than the next four. And that's how we do it. So that's just the rotating dial, set it where you want, you get an instant effect. That's as simple as that. Spiral rollers only ever go in one direction with the crop. A little bit more going on with the clod rollers. So on every machine we produce, we always drive the clod rollers in pairs. So on this machine, we've got six clod rollers split into pairs. So one and two, three and four, and five and six on the end there. The switches below there change the direction. So we're changing the speed on one and two there, and we're changing the direction on one and two directly below that. Again, the same with three and four, and again, the same with five and six. And that's where we do our fine tuning of the machine. Really, once the machine is mechanically set, and we've got the spiral rollers running at the speed we're looking to run them at, we just do the fine tuning on the three clod roller speeds. The other two buttons on the bottom here, raise and lower, it is an option. most people do go for it. That is to lift the clod rollers up and down. Now on this six row and our four row machine, we can lift all the clod rollers up vertically, or actually around the arc of the spiral roller, so we're maintaining the gap between the clod roller and the spiral roller. And we can do that remotely on these two buttons. There's a electric actuator just on the top of the machine there that operates a linkage, and that lifts all the rollers on both sides. Nice and easy, if you like. We've got a basic indicator on the side of the machine to show you what position we're at. Again, we can go another level on top of that and have a readout of a percentage of where that clod roller is. The PLC system, again, that works on a percentage, and that's memorised in this menu as well. One more little switch on the end here that's worth noting is a water spray. So, what we have on here, just underneath the machine, we have a spray bar. You can have one or two, depending on how large the machine is. The eight row machine, for example, has two spray bars on it. That's not a system where we're looking to get potatoes wet. It's just a situation when, if it's very, very dry conditions, and we really would like a little bit of soil to build up on the leading edges of the ribs to take the aggressiveness out of it, if you like. We like to see some soil on here. We can just pop that spray bar on or off, perhaps only for 10 minutes in each hour, and any dust that's coming through with the potatoes will, over time, stick and build up on the spiral rollers, just to soften the action of how it works. So that's done remotely on there. We can also do that as on a timer, and again in the PLC system we can put that on a timer as well. So it's quite an easy thing to understand. It does what it says on the tin, as I said before. It's often advisable just to, if you're running different types of crops, that you just make a note of what settings you're at, then you can just go back and refer to it. But we also supply an overview and some recommended settings from most aggressive to least aggressive, which you can also offer as well. We'll send that out by email, and it'll be on our website. So that's our control box.